All right, Ashley, in honor of St. Patty's Day, looks like today we're going to Raglan Road, checking it out.
We are at Raglan Road today, checking it out for the festivities of St. Patty's Day. So we'll go through the menu.
It's better than the last time we sat here. Once again, this will be in the description below. It's probably hard to see on here. Huge menu. I'm going to the other side for food. And of course, it's dinner time. And yeah, we'll show you what you got. We'll go through it and we'll show you something that shows as well.
Sansa says, I'm going to get the fish and chips. Ashley's still working on hers. And then for drinks.
So drink-wise, Ashley ended up with the Strawberry Fields Mimosa and I ended up with the Irish, or Iced Irish. So we'll tell you how those are as well. And for Ashley's dinner today, looks like she's going to get the Gnocchi C and Gnocchi D. So see how those are. We'll let you know how those are. And we're also, it looks like the show is starting as well. So we'll
give you guys a view of that as well.
Opinions on the end, and I have my Irish cream, which looks very good. So we're going to be trying these out a little bit different today because given the scenario and the background as well.
So we'll let you know at the end how everything is, but enjoy the entertainment.
We'll rate the bread, but we got some traditional Irish bread, some Guinness, and some olive oil, and we'll be trying this out. So let's go. We all know Alex drinks a lot quicker than Ashley. So, second up, we have a berry margarita. So I'll let you know how this is. Like I said, everything's gonna come at the end. We're gonna do it a little bit differently than we do. So we're gonna show you everything, and then at the end, in our final thoughts, we'll go through everything. Again, reviews are all gonna come at the end for everything. But first up, what did you end up getting?
A serious steak.
Serious steak,
and it looks like it has some onion rings on top.
Yes, it does.
And then here's my fish and chips. We're gonna try these out. Like I said, we're gonna give you guys some more live entertainment. And we'll do final thoughts and we'll go over everything at the end. So once again, that's the serious steak. Fish and chips right here, really good portion size. And enjoy the show.
Thank you. So just so you know, Ashley swapped it up for a second drink. We have the raspberry mint lemonade. So once again, this is going to all be a review at the end. We'll give our final thoughts on everything, go through each of our dishes, and we'll also be getting a dessert. We're just showing you guys everything while the entertainment is happening.
So it feels like dinner just flew by, but we're already on dessert. So here are some of your dessert options. Been here for just about an hour. Like we said, we will go through each of our meal choices at the end and give you guys an idea just because of the environment here. But really nice, really cool place to check out, especially for St. Patrick's Day. All right, so it looks like Ashley made a good suggestion. We're gonna get the bread and butter pudding, because who doesn't like the tagline of, like, no other you've ever tried. So you can't go wrong there. We'll try it. All right, so our dinner has just been enhanced. We were just handed a candle.
It's a real candle.
It's now a very romantic date now. I guess
yes,
this is now a fancy occasion. I didn't know it. So bread and butter pudding here. Ashley, you want to do the honors?
They gave us two different sauces.
So we got a butterscotch. Ooh, what is that? Is that like a whipped cream type?
I don't know. I'm just pouring.
Your job's just to pour.
Yeah.
All right, next one. Next one up.
I like this one, the butterscotch.
Yes. Let's go for the butterscotch. Ooh, yes, you are correct.
Oh, we're about to overflow.
We're good?
Hey.
No spillage. All right, so we're gonna try this out. Like I said, all of our thoughts and opinions on everything today will be going up at the end in our final segment. So as you can see, we had a lot of entertainment to enjoy. We have a lot of meals to enjoy, so let's dig in. At least no dinner is complete without Alex getting a drink. So I have my Bailey's Irish Cream. Even though I'm lactose intolerant, this is gonna be fantastic. And we're already digging into the bread pudding, which is fantastic as I can taste right now. So final thoughts at the end. Thanks so much for watching. As you can see, a lot of entertainment here. Really awesome here at Raglan Road, highly recommended. But we'll give you guys final thoughts coming up.
hopefully.
As you can tell by the video, many weeks ago, yes, almost a month ago, we went to Raglan Road, which is in Disney Springs, downtown Disney. So we went there a little bit before St. Patrick's Day. We originally were intending to put that up, but with everything kind of how craziness
kind of held on to it
in March, we've held on to it. But this is one that it's one of our favorites for an overall entertainment and dining experience. It's really great to see the dancers. It's really great to hear the music as well.
Yeah,
I think one of my favorite things is when they're a little bit more, what's the word, where they keep going with the crowd where you can sing along. They have a little bit more relatable songs. Last time I think they had a couple, and I learned a couple new songs as well, but they had a couple that we could sing
that you were obsessed with.
And this go around when we went there, there were a little bit less. There was an original song which was really hard to follow along on because we weren't really aware of the lyrics, so we weren't really prepared for what our part of it
sing-along
was. But they have a really good experience. I feel like the dancers are always fantastic. It's really a good time. Food's really good as well. So as we said in the video, we're going to go through what we thought of our meal, because it was very difficult to shoot any footage in there to get our voices because it is very loud. Now, one thing I'll preface this with is the last time we were in a corner where we could barely see the stage. This time we lucked out tenfold because we could actually see the stage very well, and there were people even behind us. So we would definitely recommend getting reservations because it helps you to have a better chance, because if you're sitting at the bar all the way in the back, the bar is basically behind where me and Ashley were sitting. There are going to be people in your way if you do not have reservations, so you have a better bet of getting a better spot if you do have reservations. Aside from that, fish and chips, really good. It's just a very small portion size in my opinion. That's one of my only critiques about it. But the fish and chips, I would give like an 8.5 out of 10. It's really good taste wise they have like the tartar sauce and everything else, so it's good. The fries are really good as well. It's just portion size. I wish it was a little bit bigger, but it's understandable given that they have to have the entertainment with it and that they're pricing in the entertainment with your meal for what you pay. So aside from that, dessert, bread pudding for me, fantastic. That was a 10 out of 10. That was one of my favorite desserts that we've had in quite some time, probably this year, 2020. Surprisingly. It's It's probably one of the more healthy ones, too. That was one of my favorite desserts. I really like the topping on it.
It was not healthy at all.
It was more healthy than some of the stuff we've had, in my personal opinion. I always thought bread pudding was a little bit more healthier than of an option.
And then we poured butterscotch and white chocolate all over it. That did not make it healthy.
I think overall it wasn't probably very healthy by the time we were done with it.
Butter bread pudding.
Even better? Yeah, probably not. But it wasn't ice cream, so I guess it's that. So Ashley, what were your thoughts on your meal?
I vividly remember one of my drinks. Just one. The Strawberry Fields Mimosa. Which, I was irritating him the whole day with it, because I kept singing it like Strawberry Fields forever. Really good. I would recommend it. I really like my steak. The Serious Steak.
Serious Steak.
Yes. The only gripe that I had with it was the onion rings. I'm not a big onion ring person, and like there were two really, really big ones on it. But other than that, it was a really good meal. I'd say I'd give it like a solid like eight and a half. Yeah, it was really good.
I mean, my drinks were all right. I feel like the first one was just all right. The second one that had some mixed berries where it had some like...
The mixed berry margarita.
Mixed berry margarita was my favorite out of them. It wasn't the best drink I've ever had. I'd probably give landed at a 7.5 and 8. But it was good from the options that you could select from. I know there's a lot on their menu. So as with all the other videos, I'm going to leave the menu below so you can take a look.
Oh, I never got to do the butter bread pudding.
Yeah, and butter bread pudding.
I very much so like the butter bread pudding. My only gripe was that it had raisins in it.
I thought it was a good taste.
That was what Alex thought made it healthy.
I thought that made it healthy. That was my opinion. The raisins made it healthier.
Also, we don't normally rate bread and the stuff, but I really like it.
Oh, that they made?
Yeah, with the Guinness and sugar glaze with olive oil. I really like it.
That's fair. I mean, overall, it's a really cool time. It's usually you can get reservations fairly decently out. Me and you probably got them about a month or two before St. Patrick's Day. Mind you, that's probably one of the biggest holidays to fill up there.
Yes.
But usually we've been successful in getting reservations there a month in advance or so. So something if you want to go to, plan ahead a little bit. You had a thought?
Oh, yes, I did. The videotaping does the dancers no justice. At all. I told him this while I was watching and editing it. The main feature of Irish step dancing is the stepping, which involves their feet.
Which we couldn't capture as much now. Yes. I have a different opinion because I remember this vividly because I was the one recording it. I had an issue getting their feet because there were people all the way in front of us. That was my personal issue with it. We weren't all the way up in front. So there were a couple heads in the way. I was trying to avoid getting those, so I had tried to shoot a little higher than their feet. That was part of my thought process when I was shooting it, is I didn't want to get random people's heads in it, regardless of whether it was the back of their head, so I was just trying to get a full capture without having kind of any other guests' heads in it. So I was trying to just get what we could get, but I think it gives a good idea of what the entertainment is like. But it is definitely something that you have to go there to check out.
Yeah.
Is definitely what I would recommend. Definitely don't just go by the video because there is a lot of kind of differences that you can get depending on when you go. Like we went so far 2 times.
Yes, we've been twice.
And I feel like we had 2 different experiences. Not in a bad way, but 2 different experiences.
It was just 2 different bands.
With 2 different bands and even some of the dancing kind of more competitive this time. I felt like we had an extra additional female dancer than last time. It was 2 and 2 last time.
Okay.
I thought it was 1 and 2, but okay. Yeah, so, I mean, overall, it's a really fun time, really cool place to check out when the park's in, when Disney Springs reopens, so hopefully that's at a safe kind of time point, and that's also going to be a fun time for everyone when everything does open up. I know we're looking forward to going out of the house when it's safe to do so. We would appreciate having Disney back in our lives, but for now we are
going crazy
doing the best we can
it.
With what we're allowed to do. And aside from that, I think we're running down to a couple videos a week, so I think we're just going to be doing 1 Disney video, 1 or 2 home vlogs a week going forward. I think we have 1 or 2, maybe 3 Disney videos after this. We'll see. 2. So We're going to try to do that just to make it last a little bit longer. Unfortunately, we both...
We're going to run out.
We both have a sense that we're going to run out because we don't believe the parks are going to open until at earliest probably June, first week of June. Maybe late May. We're not sure.
Maybe July.
Maybe July. So there's a lot of time frames getting floated around, but we're going to do the best with what we have. We'll give you guys an update, and if not, we will home vlog some of our Disney top 10, top 5 lists, and even give you guys some recommendations for some cool Disney movies to
and
check out.
And maybe some ducklings.
And maybe some ducklings.
Ooh.
In the nice afternoon walk-arounds, or evening walk-arounds, because we always do it relatively late, but... As always, thanks so much for watching. If you have any suggestions for when the parks do open, please be sure to leave them below because we will definitely need them. And as always, I'm Alex.
I'm Ashley.
And this is Disney's Party of Two.